good story is always worth retelling. A good story reminds us of our past, help define our present, and give us some direction for the days ahead. A good story can challenge and motivate us. It can inspire and encourage us. A good story can move us to laughter, or maybe even to tears. Best of all, a good story can help us make sense of the world we live in. But a great story, well, that's a little more difficult to find. A great story is one we can cherish and hold dear. A great story impacts our lives and changes us forever. And the greatest story of all? It's the one that involves the commonplace and the miraculous, the humble and the majestic, the ordinary and the unbelievable. It's a love story we can never fully comprehend or in our wildest dreams even imagine. Shared for centuries, it's still the greatest story ever told. There's so much we don't know about the Christmas story. Some of the images we associate with it are really just the product of our imaginations. But what we do know comes directly from God's Word. Just now, listen again, as if for the very first time. Now the birth of Jesus Christ happened this way. After his mother Mary was engaged to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with the child by the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, had in mind to divorce her privately. But while he thought on these things, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. For he who is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." When she saw him, she was troubled by his words and considered in her mind what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Listen, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said, "I am the servant of the Lord. May it be unto me according to your word."
Thank you.
We all know that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, just as the prophet Micah predicted. But we don't know exactly how Mary and Joseph go there. Did they walk? Did Mary ride a donkey? And when the baby Jesus was laid in a manger, was that because this new family had found shelter in a stable, or a barn, or even a cave meant for the cattle? Truth is, we just don't know. Same area, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Thank you. Did they really sing? Did they shout? Or did they merely speak? The angels, I mean. What was their tone of voice when they made their incredible proclamation to those unsuspecting shepherds? It's difficult to imagine that with such fantastic news to share, they'd be anything less than animated and excited, isn't it? Here's how the Bible describes it. And then an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were very afraid. But the angel said to them, "Listen, do not fear, for I bring you good news of great joy, which will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in strips of cloth, lying in a manger." Suddenly, there was with the angel a company of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, goodwill toward all." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see what has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they came hurrying and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they made widely known the word which was told them concerning this child, and all those who heard it marveled at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Light, whether from a small candle or the sunshine of a spring day, light is something we cannot live without. It illumines the world around us so that we can see and understand. It brings us warmth so that we can live and grow. It is a source of life itself. In sending His Son, God has given a light that will shine forever. It is a light of truth. It is a light of wisdom. It is a light of joy to all who will accept it. Take this light of peace to all mankind. It is Christmas. God is with us. We bring His light. Christmas, a season of joy, a time of hope, a promise of peace. Emmanuel has come. God is with us. Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. These words of Isaiah have come true for our time, and yet the Messiah beckons us still for lasting peace in our troubled world. Let us worship him with songs of joy, but let us serve him with hands and feet that bring good news to a hungry world. Let us proclaim the peace of Christmas in the holy name of the one who came to us, Jesus Christ, that we might live forever with him. Amen.